for multiplayer was released, and they showed a whole bunch of gameplay, a whole bunch of everything, and it looks freaking awesome. A lot of people got to play it, and I am completely jealous of that, because I have to wait until the damn game comes out. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm gonna do a trailer breakdown for you, every single thing. I will tell you what it's about, and anyways, let's just get straight into the trailer. Enjoy, guys, and I'll catch you in a moment. Oh my freaking god, that was damn awesome. That trailer looked freaking sick. I cannot wait for this game to come out. So right here, automatically, we see that there's a guy up there. And now in any normal Call of Duty, what we would do is basically shoot the guy and continue running. We would have no idea how we got up there or anything. But with this Call of Duty, because there's exoskeleton suits, you'll see in a moment here that we are able to actually jump on top right after and easily break through the glass. So just watch right here as you kill him. You jump up, and that was actually pretty damn sick. So now all we see is a first blood thing on the screen. Now that one looks pretty damn awesome, and it also says on the left, like every other Call of Duty, who was the first one to get the first blood, blah blah blah, stuff like that. And when you jump down here, you see the glass break. But the glass didn't break because you jumped by force, it broke. No. What you actually see is a red laser beam right there, which is one of the new guns that use direct energy, so it's pretty damn awesome about those guns. I love those things. They look like they're gonna be pretty overpowered, but at the same time, there's no reloading. So when your gun actually does come to an end, you use all the energy, you have to wait a while, but we'll see that later on in the trailer anyways. But let's move on right here. You shoot that guy right there, and you see the shotgun waves. And now a lot of people are saying that the shotgun waves are going to be kind of annoying. It's gonna distort your vision. But if you think about it, it's actually only for a second, and you can see everything around you right after that. It doesn't last long. You don't have to worry, and nonetheless, it's pretty damn awesome, I would say. So, you see the guy continue running, and someone just comes in the middle of the screen. You can see he jumped pretty high, but we're not going to talk about that right now. We'll see that in a moment as well, and here's the shotgun waves, of course. So you continue running, and right here you see that you have your, what's it called? Yeah, a lethal grenade and a tactical grenade, and it comes out of something attached to your arm, which is pretty damn sick. And what I have to think about these things is, like, the lethal comes out of the right arm, I believe, and the tactical comes out of the left. But this is only if you're using those type of things. There's other things you could use also instead of lethals and tacticals that we'll also get into in a moment. But let's continue here for a second. And right there you see that your guy is marked. The guy is marked red, and that's because of the lethal that you, the tactical that you just used. And you can see a little guy right there behind the wall as well, because that's where your grenade hit and targeted them. And this guy is actually using a cloaking suit, as you can see. But because you use that, you're able to see him clearly, and honestly, I hope the cloaking isn't overpowered in this game. I hope you don't sit in a dark corner and no one can see you whatsoever. That would kind of freaking suck. But anyways, we continue here. And right there, your whole screen just goes red. Again, that only lasts for a second. It's not long whatsoever. A lot of people are getting annoyed of it, but personally, it's not gonna bother me at least. But that is just me. I have no idea. helicopter, and